Welcome to our video presentation on the Ideal World Class Billionaires. I would like to introduce our team members. My name is Caroline. Over here is Kalaya. This is Kasiri, and this is Kantarat. Today we are going to talk about our ideal billionaires, Giovanni Ferraro, who ranked number 30 in Forbes billionaire list. This talk is divided into 9 topics as following. First, Kalaya will tell you about his reason for admiring awareness, awareness, charity, and social distribution. Next, Caroline is going to talk about his personal background and information, educational history, capacity, and talent. After that, Kansili will talk about his early life, company, and line of products. Then Kantarat is going to tell you about his career background. Our talk will last about 10 to 15 minutes. Now, Kalaya will start by telling you about the reason that our team admires him as the ideal billionaires.
Thank you, Caroline, for the reason that your team admires him as the ideal billionaire, because he is the leader in the racer industry with popular brands Rayutala and Ferrero Rocher, and he dare to change and turn a crisis into an opportunity by developing products for business success. And because with the money he had, he could buy a mansion, but he only bought a house to live in and used part of the money to expand the business. That is the end of the past. I will now hand you over to Caroline.
Thank you, Kalaya. For personal background and information, Giovanni Ferraro, born in 21 September 1964, he is an Italian businessman and writer. He assumed the leadership of the confectionery company Ferraro Spa after the death of his brother Pietro Ferraro in 2011. As of October 2022, he had an estimated net worth of $37.6 billion, making him the 28th richest in the world and richest person in Italy. This leads to the next point. I will pass you over to Kansiri.
Thank you, Caroline. For his early life, he was born in Feligliano, Italy, the son of Maria Fenga Fistolo and Michele Ferraro, the owner of the multinational confectionery corporation Ferraro. Giovanni Ferraro's career in the confectionery industry began at a young age. After completing his education, he returned to Europe to work in the family company. He rose through the rank and eventually became joint CEO of Ferraro with his brother Pietro in 1997. Following his brother's death in 2011, Giovanni became the sole CEO of Ferraro Group. That is the end of this past. I will now hand you over to Kantarat.
Thank you, Kansiri, for his career background. The Ferraro Group was founded by Pietro and Giovanni Ferraro in 1946. The owner has founded it earlier in 1923 in Domremy, Italy, but Pietro shop was not very successful, so he moved to the Italian city of Alba later founding the Ferraro Group. Unfortunately, Pietro died in 1949. In 1956, Pietro and son Michel took the Ferraro Group into the German and European market and started production as an industrial factory, causing the Ferraro Group to become even stronger. However, in 1957, Giovanni Ferraro, aged 52, died, leaving Michel to carry on the business alone. In 1997, Michel had to step down as CEO and pass the power on to his two sons, Pietro and Giovanni, the same name as both grandfather, but in 2011, a tragic accident occurred and Pietro died unexpectedly, and during the next 4 years, Michel passed away from OS. The Ferrero Group is currently managed by Giovanni Ferrero, who is now the third generation of the company. That is the end of my part. I will now hand you over to Caroline.
Thank you, Cantara. For educational history, in 1975, he moved to Brussels, Belgium, where he studied at the European School. Then he moved to the US, where he studied marketing at Lebanon Valley College. This leads to the next point, capacity and talent. Generally, an executive with another special talent is the writer of a highly effective and responsive work, namely Marketing Progetto 2000. La Gesta della Complicità in 1990. Listen to it here. Works such as Deli di Tenebra 1999, Compo Paradiso in 2007, and Il Canto delle Farfalle in 2010. This is the end of my part. I will pass you over to Kansiri.
Thank you, Caroline, for company and line of product. Company, Burton Biscuit Company, International, Penny May, Ferrara Candy Company, Fox Biscuit, Kipler Company, Mother Cookies, Royal Dance, Thornton, Well Enterprises, Line of Product, Baby Root, Butterfinger, Crunch, Famous Famous, Ferrero Cushion, Ferrero Rocher, Moncherry, Nutella, Pocket Coffee, Raffaello, Chic Tap, Ferrara Candy Company, Kinder, Well Enterprises. That's it, the end of this part. I will now hand you over to Kalea.
Thank you, Kansiri, for award and honors. In 2023, the Ferrero brand was home to some of Italy's best and most famous brands will be ranked. And Giovanni Ferrero has received numerous awards and recognition for his contribution to the confectionery industry. These include Cavalier del Lavoro, Knight of Labor from the Italian government, honorary degree from the University of Turin, EY World Entrepreneur of the Year Award in 2018. This leads to the next point, charity and social retribution, corporate social responsibility. Our pact of responsibility affects every aspect of our company and every state of our supply chain, from supporting sustainable farming practices and performing rigorous quality controls to promoting healthy and active lifestyle. That is the end of my part. Thank you.
This is the end of our presentation. Thank you for your time. It was my pleasure being here today.